The motto for world-class competition has always been faster, higher, stronger. It's the same for Navien, makers of condensing tankless water heaters. Faster to install and set up. Higher performance and efficiency to provide endless hot water. Stronger with the industry's strongest warranty. All because of the copper-free stainless steel heat exchanger built in every unit. Learn about Navien's condensing tankless water heaters and find a Navien contractor at tanklessmadesimple.com. That's tanklessmadesimple.com.
I was at home, and I get this call from Ring.
We just received a fire alarm. Is all okay?
My fire alarm in our cottage was going off. And then it hit me. My parents are at the cottage. The fire had started in the chimney and spread to the roof. Ring Alarm Professional Monitoring dispatched the fire department before we even could dial 911. My name is Kevin, and Ring Alarm helped save our family cottage.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/odyssey. That's ring.com/odyssey.
Hey, Ola, it's Miles. Thank you guys for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast.
Have you heard our newest podcast? It's called The Greatest Story Never Told.
Download it today on radio.com. Be sure to subscribe. New episodes are uploaded every Tuesday at noon.
Back to the conversation. This is the Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Coming up in minutes. We will drink, we will toast to the shot of the day into the weekend, then the return of Bad Choice Friday! You know it's Bad Choice Friday.
It's Bad Choice Friday! Hey man, this is your fault!
Jam on! Follow us on Twitter at Men's Room Live, get there and vote now for Survivor!
Of the Tigre.
Survivor taking on the one and only from Everett, Washington, Kenny Loggins. Kenny Loggins and Survivor, there are your choices on Bad Choice Friday as we bring it back this afternoon, right after the shot of the day. Now time for a few emails from the men's room at mensroomlive.com. As we jump right into the birthday request, let's see what we got here. Please wish my son Preston, pronounced Car Show, a happy birthday. Have Coach Ted give him a pep talk as he will be playing in a fall brawl 7-on-7 football tournament this weekend in Boise, Idaho. That from Mom, Dad, and T-Bone.
What's his name again?
His name is Car Show, a.k.a. Preston.
Preston, here's the deal, man. What I need you to do in the first quarter, slant. Second quarter, go routes. Now, what are we setting up for? What we've been setting them up for all year. That's why we're in this tournament. You hit him with that sluggo route. Enjoy the touchdown. Hand it to the ref. Be a professional.
Bitches, we want to give our good friend, the goddamn Bearcat, a happy birthday. Please have the dirtiest of Germans telling him how to throw down and let his freak flag fly. That from the old snake. Thanks, guys.
Yeah. I like your friend, the old snake. For your birthday, I want to introduce you to the new snake. And you can let your freak flag fly on my flagpole. That is made out of skin.
So I'm just a little worried about your friend. Because he's the one that gave Eve that apple. The old snake.
Yeah, the old snake.
So in Germany, we love Bible jokes.
Guys, birthday shout out to my son, Aaron. He's 28 years old. How about a big old Leroy Jenkins and a cut that bitch off next caller? Love the show. That from Michael, a.k.a. the dad.
Let's do this. Leroy Jenkins!
Wait for it.
Oh, the joy lord.
Whoops.
Oh, oh, there you go.
Sorry, happy birthday, I slipped up there, Aaron.
Cut that bitch off. Next call.
You don't remember the
Everything's coming back.
Oh, yeah. Okay, the vagina gave
you. Vagina. And.
The vagina game.
We will bring that back. We'll put two pictures up on Twitter. You guess who owns said piece of property.
Oh, I thought it was going to be like, which one's this? Which one's a sandwich?
Which one is Arby's?
One is an open-faced roast beef sandwich. The other.
No, it had a mushroom gravy. You picked wrong.
Yeah. That is, in fact, poutine.
I don't know what's wrong with her.
But, Charles, I'd like to give myself a birthday shout-out. I think I'd love your penis is too small. You like that? And the dirty Germans tell me how to best spend my birthday evening. Thanks, guys, and keep doing what you do. That from Cameron.
The penis is too small.
Yeah, for your birthday, have to have a good time. I would suggest using the fleshlight. And if that doesn't work, then run warm water over a dish sponge.
Yeah, so one thing I would tell you to do is not put it inside of silly putty. Turns out that putty isn't as silly as you think.
Yeah, it becomes serious putty.
Yeah.
Howdy, fellas. I want to wish my son Roy a happy birthday. He is 29 today. Let's see here. Can I get a big old bong rip for him? Thanks, guys. You make the commute bearable. Keep up with the great stuff. That from Papa Chives.
Papa Chives.
Papa Chives.
I like that name.
I feel like he's marrying the Mrs. Potato Head.
I just want to wish my brother Chris a happy birthday. Chris is the best big brother and source of free labor a little brother could ask for. Can he get the dirty Germans wishing him a happy birthday and a your penis is too small? Thanks, guys. That from Derek, who says, go Dolphins.
Yeah, it's funny that in that email he was talking about the little brother. Tonight you'll be with a big brother.
Yeah, this will be one extra German just watching. Stefan's, I love a little brother.
A brother.
Action.
Look good in them jeans, boy.
Finn's fans, huh? You don't see a lot of them.
Because there aren't a lot of them.
It's actually, I'll be with one on Sunday.
Really?
Yeah, I had a friend. He's Air Force. He traveled around. So he became Dolphins fan.
I'm not joking. That's literally why he's a Dolphins fan.
It's the lamest reason why ever.
Yeah, he's really into it.
Guys, happy 32nd birthday to my ass of a husband, Kyle, my beer partner for life. Love your wife, Haley, and daughter, Kylie. Can we get Ozzy Ted talking about the rubbing the meat that he just got for his new barbecue and his brisket, please?
Hey, Ted here from Melbourne. Tell you one of the most important things about meat, rubbing it down. Second most important part about rubbing meat, don't let the dog eat it.
Thank you, Ted.
Before it hits the grill, make sure it stays out of the canine.
Goddamn dog ruined my dinner, man.
What kind of steaks were they? Were they like the expensive ones that you bought?
They were expensive. I don't remember exactly the cup. They were expensive. I heard about them all day. They've been marinating all day. The house still had that smell of marinating steak. And said of the three steaks that were purchased, there was half of one left that had been chewed sitting on the floor in my dog's mouth.
And then after you gave everyone the thumbs up on the fact that your dog used the bathroom and didn't have any problems, the dog crapped all over your steps?
Yeah, the next day the dog pooped down the steps, luckily got a steam cleaner, but then I guess the steam cleaner also went down the stairs. Oh. So the dude, yeah.
Did you still cook dinner? Is that one of those
We ordered Chipotle, friend.
All right, I was going
to
say.
Because it's like, dinner plans were ruined. So it's like, what do you want? And I'm not trying to be essay, but it's like, well, what do you want? And I'm like, I don't even care anymore. So I ended up with Chipotle.
I hope you got a chicken burrito, not steak.
I did get I got barbacoa.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Ooh.
All the bitches, my brother Jared and I are turning 27 years old today. Can I get the dirty Germans talking about twins? Keep on rocking, guys. That from Jason in San Antonio, Texas.
Yeah, I would love to show you my twins. They are located directly below my twig.
Yeah, generally when I think of these twins, they're like blonde. But, you know, you fellas will work.
Yeah, not tonight.
By the way, can you bring the wigs?
Yeah, of course I will bring the wigs and the figs. You know me.
And the twigs.
Wigs and figs, yeah. I will bring my fig wig.
All the bitches, my wife doesn't listen to the show unless she's with me, so I'm sending myself a birthday shout. Please send me a thrill get or two and a barbershop fish sandwich. Thanks and happy birthday to me. That's from Vester in Reno, Nevada.
Get a fish sandwich. Get. So you know I got it right.
Get.
And I had a fish sandwich.
Get.
Cheese and the tartar on the side.
Get.
Guys, my husband turned 38. He's a huge fan. I'd love to give him a shout out to John Brady with love from his amazing wife. Why don't you give him a D is too small and some dirty Germans, please? Thanks, guys.
That from the lovely Patty.
She didn't hold back on that.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just Patty Cake is talking about. It is not too small. Everyone needs a Q-tip.
Yeah, so you know what? My husband's Patty enjoys a melt. There'll be something gooey on her tonight.
Yeah, sounds not appetizing.
Yeah, well, you know, so might be an onion involved.
Hello, Charles. It's me, the Asian Italian Canadian, emailing to request a birthday shout out from my boyfriend, Josh Fox, in DuPont. I know he'd love the dirty German's birthday. He's originally from Arkansas. So if you have something to add to that in a funny, maybe German Southern accent, that would be great, too. Thanks, guys. That from Andrea in British Columbia, Canada.
Yeah, if you are from Arkansas, you are familiar with the Razorback. And I have the feeling when you see Ted's back, you will also think of the Razor.
Yes, that's a good cause, y'all. So I've been down here. So, no, down here in Arkansas, y'all. We're saying, whoop, pig suey. That's a tough one, a German doing a southern accent.
It's a lot. It's a layer. But tell those guys, today's my boyfriend's 44th. We're both big fans of the show, and I'd love and appreciate if you guys could wish Frank a happy birthday with a little turtle sex and some dirty Germans. You guys are great. Stay safe, and thanks. That from the lovely Emily.
Yeah, Emily, I appreciate you sending your Frank, because I want to show him my beans.
Yeah, something to show us the cans they came in.
Pachalos, my name is Jill, a.k.a. Jillo, for my fabulous Jillo shots. My friends all know I'm not keen on social media, so they probably would never think I would dig a birthday shout-out, so I'm doing it for me. Guys, I listen to the show at work and on the way home, oftentimes experiencing a good old belly laugh, so thanks so much for that. Those are in short supply these days. I'm celebrating the 19th anniversary of my 29th birthday, and I would love a Leroy Jenkins, and oh my God, what the hell is that, bro, and a little barbershop quartet with cheese and tartar on the side. Thanks, brothers. Keep doing what you're doing. That from Jillo.
Oh my God, what the f*** is that, bro?
Can I get a fish sandwich? Oh, you know I gotta eat right. Oh, brother, can I have a fish sandwich? You put the cheese and the tartar on the side.
Guys, I want to wish my high school sweetheart and love my life, Matthew, a happy 51st birthday today. The most loving, supportive, and loyal man I know. Couldn't ask for a better partner. Please give him some of Thrill's Gets and the Dirty Germans talking about how good he is as a hard rock miner. Thanks, guys, for the show. Keep on rocking. From his little trouble, Julie.
Get. Yeah, it's a good thing you are so good looking for these hard rocks, because I have a very hard surface for you.
Yeah.
It's like a stalactite.
Sounds like a man who's good digging through caves.
Yeah, I'll dive to my cake till you find my rocks.
It's a hard rock miner. You know, I can still play that note.
Can you?
Yeah.
It's impressive. Guys, I have a very special chosen dad today. He's 52 years old. He only allows and listens to The Rock since he was my age. And he keeps saying, can you please wish him a happy birthday for my sister and I from Independence, Kentucky? Since we can't be home in Washington State to celebrate with him, can you give him a too early for a fish sandwich and the German naughty talk birthday wishes as well? Happy birthday, Bobaroo. Thank you, guys. That from Jack.
Too early to get a fish sandwich?
Yeah, it's funny, because by the time we are done tonight, you'll be calling me by the same name, Jack.
Yeah, you know, where I come from, you have to pay extra for that.
Yeah.
Since I mean, it's a birthday. I also like the way you said it was naughty.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, anybody can be dirty, but it's, you know, naughty is a little more central. So that involves a bratwurst.
Yeah, and fecal matter.
All right, guys, here you go.
Happy birthday to you. Yaws of Dirty Germans, brought to you by Men's Room Original Sausage. Available through Uli's World Famous Sausage, mensroomlive.com, and other fine retailers. Schweinefly.
Thank you. I have a couple extra emails here. Yesterday was a hell of a day with Kicks for Kids. Kicks for Kids Day got about $36,000 altogether.
Yes, it did.
Donations thanks to you. By the way, you can still head to KISW.com, make a donation if you couldn't do so yesterday. Plus, trust me, the folks at Mary's house would be Mary's place, would be very, very happy about that. So a couple extra donations from yesterday we didn't get to. Guys, I donated to Kicks for Kids. The amount I donated was $6.90 of the last $10 I have. Rock on, guys.
Damn.
That from Kirk. Just donated $99.90. Looking forward to the next pie in the face. Go Kicks for Kids. Love the show. Been listening forever. That from Jason. You guys rock, bitches. I only had $25 to donate, but it's for a great cause. Thanks for doing what you're doing. You guys make me smile and laugh out loud every day. That from the lovely Barbara. Barbara, thank you for that. Eric and Jamie joined the 69 Club. Mix's deal. I mean, it is what he. It's
a, I know it's
what he's known for, isn't it?
When it's red like that, it sounds so
exactly.
Oh, they joined the 69 Club. Nixes to you. I don't know.
Hola Pie Faces. If you're wondering, we took pies to the face yesterday. If you happen to like KISW on Facebook, the videos are up there. Donated $50, and I know there are some cowboy rockaholics out there. That from the Elk Plain Drifter. Send $50 for the kids to see Miles get a pie in the face. Rock on. Thanks for doing what you're doing. That from Jeff and Everett. And one more email, guys, and this is about acquiring things, and I thought you'd like this one, Ted. Bitches, as a former pub landlord here in London in 1999, I had the privilege of running a pub for the Green King Brewery. It was located in a district of London called the City, the financial region, and was closed on the weekends as all the businesses were closed. So every weekday from 11 a.m., our locals would pop in for liquid lunch and after-work activities. One Friday, my birthday, the usual crowd were in there for a few drinks. I was not working, but I was in the bar celebrating. Place was heaving, and I got completely wasted for free. Everyone was buying me beer. When I rolled out of bed the following afternoon with the worst hangover ever, I figured I might have a few drinks already paid for behind the bar. I figured I'd partake of a few hair of the dog drinks or so. I got a shock. I worked out every round that was bought by someone who also had bought me the drinks. So there were 200 people in the pub that night who over a period of 5 hours had paid for me not only what I had to drink last night, but also left me with 10 cases of St. Edmund's beer and 18 gallons of real ale already paid for. It took me months to consume my stock. Months. I miss those days sometimes. Thanks, guys, for the laughs. You guys are awesome. P.S. When you guys get the opportunity to visit the U.K. again sometime over the next few years, let us know, and I will treat you to a few beers and such, although I'm much more of a lightweight nowadays, as my work prevents me from partaking of booze as much as I would like to. Love to take you out. Stay safe, guys. Regards. That from John. Hell of an invitation there. I think we need to go back in time to the last time we played Ted versus the FCC. So if we could, let's go back in time.
At the Sit Shack, they serve hard porn core, poor core, and soft poor corn. In the Sit Shack, you sit on a sheet sack, and the sheet sacks at the sack are soft and saggy.
Three times fast.
At the Sit Shack, they serve hard poor corn and soft poor corn. In the Sit Shack, you sit on a sheet shack, and then the sheet sacks at the shack are soft and saggy?
One!
At the sit...
Yes, it was in fact a loss the last time we played Ted versus the FCC. Let's try again!
And now, everyone's favorite daytime game show, where one person could lose $325,000 and their job, or win, and walk away with nothing. It's time for Ted versus the FCC.
Oh, man, oh, man.
Yeah,
long day yesterday, all to go. We got it done, though. We came up with some unbelievable tongue twisters late last night for Ted versus the FCC. You're not going to believe this, Steve.
What's that?
We got an email from a listener.
Are you kidding me?
We have a listener submitted Ted versus the FCC.
Well, if we had known, we wouldn't have stayed up so late working so hard.
And you know, we say listener comes first.
Always.
Yeah. Most of the time. So, this one comes our way from Kevin. And Kevin says he altered this from the beloved Fox in Socks. And also adds good luck, Ted. In this week's Ted versus the FCC goes something like this. Three free fleas flocked. While these fleas flocked, Freezy Breeze blew ships. Freezy Breeze made these three ships shops freeze. The way we play Ted versus the FCC is you need to read that one time through, then three times fast.
All right. Three free fleas flocked. While these fleas flocked, Freezy Breeze blew ships. Freezy Breeze made these three ships shops freeze.
Three times fast.
Three free fleas flocked. While these fleas flocked, Freezy Breezy blew ships. Freezy Breezy made these three ships shop freeze.
One.
Three free fleas flocked. While these fleas flocked, Freezy Breezy blew ships. Freezy Breezy made these three ship shops freeze.
Two.
Three free fleas flocked. While these three fleas flocked, Freezy Breezy blew ships. Freezy Breezy made these three ships shop freeze.
That's a win! That is a win! So close.
All right. Finally back in the win column. We might be even on the air. I'm not sure, but I think we're pretty close on Ted versus the FCC. All right, bitches, here we go. Return of Bad Choice Friday is coming up, and we'll drink and toast with a shot of the day next.
You can tell when your car battery's dying. But with your water heater, you'll never know until it starts leaking. Before you buy another tank, consider a Navien tankless water heater. No storage tank to heat or leak. Lower energy bills and endless hot water for spa-like comfort. All backed by Navien's strong warranty. If your water heater is over 8 years old, it's time to check out Navien at tanklessmadesimple.com.
Count on Navien.
So we were both at work.
We started getting these notifications from Ring. I'm just like, huh. I check my camera, and there are these two guys trying to break into my house. I hit the siren on my alarm, and I immediately get this call from Ring.
Would you like for us to go ahead and send the police?
And I'm like, yeah, absolutely.
We just wanted to secure our home. My name is Ina.
And I'm Rohit. And with Ring Alarm, I stopped the break-in on my phone.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/away.
Professional monitoring requires a Ring Protect subscription.
The Men's Room is in progress. 99.9 KISW and KISW HD1 Seattle.
Coming up, we'll drink, we'll toast into the weekend. Yeah, then right after we do the shot of the day, the return of Bad Choice Friday.
Dig it!
And we do have your headlines on the way 1 hour from now. But first, quick check-in with Mike Hawk and some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
All right, there's a video going viral of a bear in Pennsylvania that was seen riding on top of a garbage truck.
Is that, for a bear, is that the equivalent of hitching a ride on a food truck?
Oh, not bad.
Are we sure it was a bear?
Yes.
Years ago, there was a movie called Teen Wolf, which was a human that turned into a werewolf.
Ted, yeah. You're on something.
Now, he would ride on top of a van.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just saying, I'm not positive it's a bear. It's going to be a man transitioning into a bear that is now riding on top of the
Where
truck.
Where did this happen?
Pennsylvania,
your trash men are werewolves.
Mm-hmm.
You're
Believe
welcome.
It or not,
bear wolves.
This COVID crap is causing the bear population and bears in general, as far as their sightings and everything, to go through the roof this year.
Well, of course,
it's been insane
because people aren't out. So
Pennsylvania, right. they're like, where are all these bears coming from?
Pennsylvania.
They're having a pretty difficult time with them.
The Army is trying something new to enhance their performance: strategic napping.
Okay, huh.
Well, I like it.
Yeah. Yeah,
I'm with you. They're basically saying, yeah. Just kind of saying, I didn't quite read the story, but they just kind of have it scheduled out, like, go take a nap now.
Well, look, I mean, it's like, what, Mexico and Japan, you know, you'd be at work, and they're like, okay, it's nap time. Right. Keep your productivity up, keep your brain sharp.
Yeah, I also like the aggressive nature. Take your nap!
Right, it's a military nap. Go do it! Private! Lay down and relax!
But Sarge, I had 3 cups of coffee.
Here's some warm milk.
I will read you a bedtime story.
I will rub your back. Take a nap.
One fish, two fish. Red fish, blue fish.
Good night, man.
Good night. Good night, socks. Good night, rocks. Good night, mouse. Good night, house.
It's actually a pretty easy one to get through, though, as far as the children's perspective is concerned.
I thought you were talking about taking a nap all the while Sergeant yells at you.
Yeah, but here's the thing I realized. So I was never familiar with Goodnight Moon until you have kids. And I swear to God, we ended up with like 8 copies. That is the first gift everyone buys you, mm-hmm. is a copy of Goodnight Moon, right? So mm-hmm. I had never read it. I got the gist, right?
Sure.
But I read it. And when I was done, I'm looking at my daughter. She doesn't quite understand English yet. And I'm like, this is a book about a crazy lady. Mm-hmm. Good night, Spoon. Like, no, don't do that.
An engaged couple with the last names Russell and Stover were given a ton of free stuff for their wedding day by candy company Russell Stover.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
All right. It worked. I don't know how they tracked that down. They must have reached out or something like that.
That's why M&M's putting on weight.
Actually, they
keep giving them to me.
Russell Stover just gave him that stuff because they're both filled with marshmallow.
What would you change your name to? I might go by Twix.
Ooh, candy-wise?
Yeah.
Yeah, Twix is good.
Payday.
Payday. You want Payday?
Mikey
wow.
Payday.
Okay, Mikey Payday.
Kit Kat.
All right, Kit Kat Smith.
Miles, where are you going?
I don't know.
You can call you Peppermint Patty.
Sure.
Yo, whatchamacallit?
I'll be whatchamacallit.
Oh, I love yeah. whatchamacallit. Yeah.
Whatchamacallit yeah, Montgomery.
Yeah. I'll name a penis Twix.
All right, Ted, you ready for this?
Fun size.
Twix are for kids.
Damn.
No, I didn't mean that.
Ted, you ready for this? Honey Baked has come up with a brand new pumpkin spice glazed turkey.
Ooh.
Pumpkin spice glazed turkey.
All right. I don't like
don't
a lot
Don't mess
of-
with my glaze, though, on my bird. You know, I want it to taste like a turkey still. Like, I want the food. I don't want my mashed potatoes to taste like pumpkins.
But the turkey is going to taste like turkey. I don't, man. If you didn't deep fry it, inevitably I'm like, great, it's turkey.
Yeah. The honey-baked ham store turkey is phenomenal.
I can believe that.
I remember the first time me and my brother, they were like, we have turkey now. We bought one home on Easter. We were celebrating like the kings we were.
Nice. I don't know that I've ever tried anything from honey-baked. I mean, I know that it's tradition to get a honey-baked ham.
Do it.
Yeah, do you like ham?
Sure, it's all right.
Okay, this, ham, I can take it or leave, right?
Sure,
honey baked ham is one of those things when you have it, you're like, this is the best ham.
I mean, it sounds delicious. I just never have actually gotten honey baked. I don't care about ham
or turkey, but if you had a deep fried turkey and honey baked ham, be like, you've hooked it up.
Mm-hmm. I mean, right, like in my family, they're for holidays, and also like you go to the beach for a week in the summer, you get a honey-baked ham so you can pick at it all week.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Make sandwiches and everything
else. Oh, yeah.
I like that style. Mm-hmm. A construction worker won $1 million in a lawsuit after his boss got drunk on the job and punched him.
$1 million for that, huh?
Right, that's kind of what I'm wondering. Like, how do you justify $1 million in damages?
I'll tell you what.
But I'm going to have Sauce Man punch me in the face. I'll even split it with you, man.
That's what I'm saying. Mike, why don't you get drunk, and then you can punch us, right?
Okay.
And then we'll just split it.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
I don't know where they're
going. But he's not our boss.
That's why we need the Sauce Man.
Co-worker who's drunk punches me in the face.
Yeah, sue the
company.
We
got to get Sauce Man to punch us.
Yeah, it has to be Sauce Man.
Okay, Sauce Man.
We'll send him the bear. Inside joke. Moving on. A man in Philadelphia broke into a...
Don't tell him what we're doing yet. He doesn't know yet.
A man in Philadelphia broke into a TV station and demanded to speak to the news anchor.
About?
I don't know. Whatever he needed to talk to him about. I'm sure that went over just about as well as you'd think.
You know, we've had that experience here, and you know, the times we've talked, not once. Security's always like, no.
Mm-hmm.
No. Because the people that say, I want to talk, like, hey, man, I need to talk to them fellas about the aliens probing my butt. Like, no, we do not want to talk to them.
I have intercepted two that I remember with this show. There was one that Ted helped me out with. I don't know if you remember that one.
Was that the phone call?
That was the phone call.
Yeah.
They were looking for the phone call. And then there was another one that they claimed that they just wanted a tour of the station, but they didn't. So they were trying to break this big story, and I just showed them the door.
We had a crazy lady waiting for us for like 2 hours. And she eventually just wrote a note. Like security finally just said, look, just write them a note. I will pass the note. And she did. She passed us along the note, and it was... it was out there, man.
Was it written in blood?
It was not written in blood. She had great handwriting. I found it unfortunate that I could read it. So I'm like, I can confirm that you are a lunatic.
Fantastic. Someone gave people a list of terms that we all use to describe how likely things are, like maybe, might happen, or probably will. And they also gave the average, what the average person means when they say them.
Okay.
All right.
So, you know what? I'm actually going to have a little bit of fun with this. Do you think that we are more likely to do something if the answer is probably or possibly?
Probably.
Possibly.
Probably.
Ted got it. 70% chance that it'll happen when it comes to probably, possibly is only 54.
All right.
Okay, more likely than not or outside chance?
More likely than not.
More likely than not.
Yeah, I'll say the same.
You guys are right. 62% of that one, outside chance was 35. Let's see. Almost certain or likely?
I'm going to go likely.
Almost certain.
Thrilly, you got it. Almost certain is the number one thing, 80% chance that it's going to happen. That is the highest rated chance right
there.
Looks
like I'm not showing up anywhere.
And likely is 67%. Now, down here, a little bit further down, we have unlikely or very unlikely. That one's easy there.
Sure.
29 and 24%. And then, let's see here, 50-50 or probably won't.
Oh, 50-50, there's a chance you're coming. If you say probably won't, then I'm just like, all right, you don't have to.
50-50.
They legit say that 50-50 is a 50% chance that we're going to do something.
That's why somebody said 50-50.
See, I don't believe the 50-50, though, because you're already leaning in one direction when you give me the 50-50.
But I feel like 50-50, Mike, you've called me, do you want to do blank? 50-50 is me telling you, I want to. You've probably sprung this on me, but I'm going to have some negotiating to do.
Sure.
But basically, she's in a good mood, so... 50. In other words, I'm trying to make this happen, but I can't guarantee.
That's fair.
Right? Yeah, I have some friends. We use percentages all the time.
I like it.
Yeah, like, can you come over next Saturday? 60%.
Yeah, perfect. I feel like that's fair. Okay.
Right, and that's good, because then you don't have to say, I don't want to. You don't say, I can't. You don't have to, you know, like you said, there's negotiation that has to take place. I got to check my calendar, make sure that I'm not stepping on anything there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pro tip, if you'd like to stay at home sometimes on the weekends, stay off social media. Because then people know you just blew them off.
Oh, sounds personal, man.
Do we know this person, Ted?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
And I know you had fun.
Why didn't they invite you?
I don't want to get into it.
All right.
Okay. I'm trying to figure out who it is. Like, I know this guy. I know exactly who it is. There's a father in Texas. We're going to go to good news stories here. There's a father in Texas that's gone viral for dancing outside of a children's hospital. His son is getting leukemia treatments inside, but only one parent can go in. So he stays outside and he dances out there on the sidewalk to keep him entertained.
Okay. All right. I like that.
I mean, I'm assuming the kids are watching him.
Right.
Okay.
Exactly.
Because if I'm, as an adult, like if I'm in a waiting room, it's like, bro, you got to stop.
I mean, the kids and the parents are watching. Everybody's kind of giving him that little side eye there. Like, what's this guy doing down there? And then when they figure out that, oh, yeah, his kid's getting leukemia treatments downstairs.
I feel like the hospital should let people know.
By the way,
he is, because look, ordinarily, if I'm sitting somewhere and someone outside in the window is dancing, like, I don't feel like dealing with this right now.
No.
Right. It's outside a children's hospital. You add his son is in there, which is unfair.
Right.
Right. Now you're just a guy dancing outside of a children's hospital.
Exactly.
It sounds bad just even coming out of my mouth.
It really does.
In a clown suit with balloons. Right. Candy. A group of teachers at a Catholic school in Miami made a parody of I Want You Back for their students.
I Want You Back by
Jackson 5.
Oh. Oh, all right.
All right.
The kids went, what is this?
Pretty much.
Who is that?
Right. Again, I think the parents truly appreciate the effort and obviously the care that these teachers have for their kids. Mm-hmm. Kids are looking at them kind of with a little raised eyebrow.
What is this song of?
Here's my thing, kids. Whether the teachers want you back or not, we want you with your teachers.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
I can promise you that.
Being like, a smile on your face.
Not be home so much.
And the administration at every school loves doing Zoom calls.
Oh, yeah.
They love it. Everyone's happy. Across the board. Teachers are happy. Students are happy. Parents are happy. It was a great time.
We're all stoked.
Everybody.
A senior water aerobics instructor in Virginia kept in touch with her class after the sessions were canceled by giving them workouts to do at home and going shopping for them. So obviously she's giving these water aerobics classes to all these elderly people that are there, and they're at the highest risk, so they're going to shut down these classes. And so she's still just reaching out, making sure that everybody's doing okay. She's sending them emails, and hey, here's a workout that you can do at home. Keep yourself moving. Keeping yourself good. She'll go to the grocery store or pharmacy, whatever they need for them.
That's pretty cool.
It is.
Water aerobics is great for older people.
It's great for everybody. You ever done it?
I
have.
You've done water aerobics?
Dude, I worked at a pool. Yes, I've done water aerobics.
I know, but still, that's the last thing I would do.
I see old people doing that, like in a pool while I'm on vacation.
Right.
That's way too early.
It's because old people do it. Nobody else wants to do it because there's a bunch of old people in the pool.
That's all right.
I mean, you know they're paying in the pool.
There's a little leakage, but other than that, I mean...
Yeah, you get mad at me. They're not even trying.
I was at a resort once, and there was like insanity. I forget who that guy was.
Yeah,
he had like insanity tapes.
Yeah,
and there was some crazy workouts those people were doing in the pool.
Really? Huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I noticed as I was sipping my cocktail.
That looks hard,
right? Is that dude gonna drown? Just, dude, take a sauna.
Grab one of them dumbbells.
Those things were great.
Push the weight around.
Just do a lap of walking. There you go. Do the little push thing. Another case of the Venmo challenge. Two men in New Mexico raised funds and gave a waitress a $1,200 tip. This, again, is that viral challenge where they'll go on there to whatever followers that they have. Their influencers are on TikTok. They're everywhere. And they say, hey, go to my Venmo, make a donation. And they give whatever donations that they get to the waitress.
Damn. Okay.
See, mine would just be hit my Venmo.
Your boy needs help. Hit my Venmo.
Right, where's he going? Probably to beer or maybe some hot dogs. I don't know.
I've been out here dressed like a bear all day. Give me in my Venmo. A photographer touring in Mexico won an award for his photo of a whale shark with a school of fish in its mouth.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's a great picture.
I thought they didn't eat fish.
No, it's not eating the fish. Oh. These fish hitch a ride in its mouth.
They're basically Picostomus in his mouth. So it looks like he has these giant teeth, and then you realize, like, those are all sucker fish in his mouth. You know what I mean? They're sucking a lot in there.
Yeah.
His teeth are probably clean.
Sure thing.
How you doing, Ted?
Not good.
Yeah, he can feel that trophy almost in his mouth.
That photo actually is crazy. If
any one black.
If you get a chance, look up that photo. It is nuts.
I am one black.
Oh, come on, man.
Whale fish.
Or
whale shark with fish in its mouth.
There you go. It's a neat photo. You're going to like that one. There is a woman in Nashville that is known for getting drunk at the local Kroger on a daily basis, and you will never guess what she did.
What did she do?
I will tell you all about it 1 hour from now.
Thank you, Mike Hawk. Headlines are on the way 1 hour from now, but first we made it to the weekend and we made it to drinking time.
If your tank water heater's over 8 years old, you may be sitting on a ticking time bomb. It could start leaking without warning, causing far more damage than the loss of the heater itself. Consider replacing it with a Navien tankless water heater. No storage tank to leak, endless hot water for spa-like comfort, longer life, and backed by Navien's strong warranty. Before time runs out, visit tanklessmadesimple.com for the name of your Navien contractor.
Count on Navien.